So I'm going to use the square tubing. This is actually, I think it's 25, no, 36. No, not 36. Yeah, what is 36? About 37. 37 by 37 millimeters. Just because I have this. And I think I have enough. So I've got these two offcuts from a previous job. So I'm going to use this length of the shorter one. The one is just a little bit shorter than the other one. For the parts that come straight out from the wall. So I'm just going to mark off on the other side exactly the same. I'm not even going to measure it. I'm just going to put them together. Put the parts here at the back, the same spot, and then just mark this one off. And then I can cut it there. I've got a saw for that. So it's going to do the cutting now. So here's my saw. I just use a stepladder on the other side to keep the workpiece level, well, as straight as possible, so it doesn't hang. So it doesn't just rely on this bracket to keep it up. Make sure everything's tight again. Bring it down onto the mark. Fasten the workpiece. I didn't start. Excellent. Bring it down, start it before you touch the workpiece, and then touch it slowly and then let the saw do all the work. Just let it go. Same length. So I'm thinking to make the foot pieces, the pieces that go onto the wall where I weld the rest of the stuff onto, the pieces that I use the roll bolts on to fasten the whole structure to the wall, because the square tubing is about 37, so let's make it 40. If you make inside 40, if you make the whole length 120, then we've got the 40 on the inside and 40 on both sides to fasten to the wall. I must just check what size my hole saw is. Okay, the hole saw I've got here is a 30 centimeter hole saw. So maybe that's not a good idea. It's gonna be only 5 millimeters on the top and the bottom over. So if I'm gonna make it 50, let's make it 50 plus 50 plus 40, so that's 140. Then I've got 50 millimeters. Just quickly check here. That is 50. It's a lot better, but maybe I should make it 60. Yeah, I think I'm gonna make it 60. 60 on the top, 60 at the bottom, and 40 in the middle. So 60 plus 60 is 120, plus 40 is 160. And I'm gonna need four of them. So what I'm first gonna do is I've got only one length of this square tubing left. So if I take 160 times that by 4, then 100 times 4 is 400. 6 times 4 is 160. So I'm going to use 560 mm of this length. And then what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to figure out, I mean, this whole thing. Let me see if I can get you close. Let's bring this down. I don't want the leg of my sexy tripod. Let's measure these ones that I just cut now. Let's quickly measure them first. One one zero one. That's the length. So the pieces, if this is the wall, pieces coming out here is 1101. So we want to know what the length is of these ones. Now this is a right angle triangle. I think that's what you call it in English, because this is a 90 degree corner. So the way you can figure out the length of this one, we want the length of this one. Now that is obviously going to depend on the length of this and this. So if we go ahead and mark these, you can use Pythagoras' theorem. Well, it's not a theorem, it's a spelling in Afrikaans. I don't know what it's in English. If you say that corner is A, that corner is B, that corner is C, then Pythagoras' whatever algorithm says the length of AC squared equals the length of AB squared plus the length of BC squared. So we got to decide now what we're going to make the length there. But what I think we must do first is I must measure the total length of the material I've got left, because if I'm going to take this, you can't see that anymore. I said I'm going to use a 560 millimeters of material for these brackets here. So I think I must take the total length I've got minus the 560, divided by 2, see how long that is, and see if I'm not going to use that whole length for here. Then we can work this out later. So okay, the total length of material I've got left is 4010 millimeter. So the only part I'm going to be able to use is 4010 minus 560. So let's do that. Let's do that here. 4010, 560 minus 1101. That can't. Take one there. You can't. Make that 3. Make that 10. But now it becomes 9. That becomes 11 minus 6 is 7. Nah, 5. 9 minus 5 is 4. And then just bring the 3 down. So the only length we can use is 3450. I divide that by 2. 3450 divided by 2. That is 1500. That is 200. That is 25. So it's 1725 millimeters per length. So I think we must use that whole length. I think we must use we must make this one 1700. Then the only thing we're going to end up with is what the hell that ever is. Yeah. So I'm going to use all the material. To work that out, you just manipulate this theorem, obviously. We want BC now. Here's BC. At the moment, it says what is AC. So to manipulate this, to bring BC over to this side, it's AC square minus BC square. Ah, frick. We want BC alone. Sorry. We want BC alone on this side. So to remove the AB square, we just, here's actually a plus, I mean just minus of it. So AC square minus AB square equals BC square. So we know AC is 1101 minus AB is 1700. Don't forget the squares equals BC square. Okay, and I think I'm going to need a calculator of that, which is on my phone. So I'm just quickly. Okay, so I quickly worked it out. I mean, when you look at this, AB square, AC square, AB. Okay. AC squared was the 1 7. I just wrote the wrong one down here. It should have been this one. When I did the calculations, I turned it around because I know obviously you can't get into a minus with this. So 1700 squared minus 11012 squared is 1677799. That equals BC squared. To get rid of this square, you've got to root it. So I rooted this 1677. So I got to the amount of 1295.29. So this length here is going to be 1295.3. That's what I'm gonna. That's the distance going to be between the top point and the bottom point. It's not really necessary to know that. I thought we're going to need to know what length this is, but I mean, due to my shortage in stock, it has to be 1 7. But I mean, we're going to use this length probably because this piece of material, I'm going to have to cut at an angle to be able to weld it correctly to this part. And I'm going to have to cut it here at a certain angle to weld it correctly to that part. So after I cut this length and I cut these four lengths, these two and those four, I will work out what the angles should be here to get this distance so that these are lined up and can fix to the wall. So I'm going to cut my shorter pieces. What did I say? I'm going to use 60 plus 60 plus 40 now. So it's 120 plus, so it's 160. I'm going to cut my four 160 pieces, and then whatever is left, I cut in half, and I'll be back with you when I've done that. Okay, so here we have our four foot pieces. Now I need to make the markings for our holes. So what is going to happen is that I'm going to use these roll bolts to fasten the foot pieces to the wall. Now I need to get a hole in this that is as large as this. I measured this is about 10 millimeters. I'm going to use a 11 millimeter drill bit. So one side must be 10 millimeter. So you can pull, fasten. But we obviously need to turn this in some sort of manner to be able to tighten it, to turn it into the roll bolt. So on the other side of this foot piece, I'm going to make a hole saw of this one. I said was 35, I think, man. 30. More 30 millimeter. So I'm going to drill a 30 millimeter hole through here, and then right across from it is going to be the 11 millimeter hole, so that I can put this through that hole and fasten it with my sockets. My socket set fits through this 35 30 millimeter hole. But obviously I need them to be exactly underneath each other. I can't use this 11mm to drill through here and then go straight through the other side, because the hole saw pilot drill bit is much smaller, and you cannot ever have a bigger hole than the pilot hole and think you're going to be able to drill with the hole saw. That's going to be impossible. So what I've got here, if I can find it, I had it here just under this. I've got a 4 millimeter drill bit. It's a lot smaller than the pilot drill bit of the hole saw. So I'm going to get my mark here. I'm going to use this drill bit while I've got the piece centered and in place. I'm going to drill through here and through the bottom all the way, one shot, one time. When I'm through all the way, I've got a 4mm hole on this side, 4mm hole on that side, right across each other. Then on the one side, I'm going to drill my 11mm hole, and the other side, my hole saw. First, we're going to mark out where we're going to do it. We said this was 160. So if I put it on 160, the middle of that is 80, and then I mark a 40 millimeter piece out, because that is where my long beam is going to come on. We've got our markings here. Okay, now we're going to use our square and draw a line all across, all the way across. There we go. There's that. Now, to find the center of this one and the center of this one, you just draw a line from corner to corner. And there's the center. There's our two middles. There's one, there's one. What we do is we take a center punch and a hammer that I can't find, the large one. Okay, so we put it on the center. The center, now we've got our little markings there, and we can easily drill through with the 11 after 4mm drill bit. So I'm going to mark the other three, and then I'll show you the drilling process. Okay, I'm going to show you the setup here. I don't know what the vibration of the drill is going to do with the camera. Okay, so we bring this up. You gotta make sure that it's centered this hole there so the bit can go through the hole, obviously. But this needs to be just above the workpiece, as close as we can get, so that it can still go through all the way. Just check it's still in the middle. And it does go through all the way. So I've got a bit of quick easing oil here. This is a formal bit that we're going to use to go straight through all the way. I'm drilling at 900 RPM. Apparently, the slower you drill, the longer your bits last. So, and obviously there's different RPMs you use for different materials. I didn't check it up. I just tried to, this is not the slowest the machine can go. The machine can go to 600, I think. Yeah. I'm going to do it on 900. So, get a bit of oil in there. Start it. Get it first one. Exactly on top of each other. Now I'm going to drill the other 7 holes and then I'll show you with the other drill bits. Now the 11 mil bit, we obviously don't want to go through all the way as we did with the 4 mil. When you go through this first one, you stop. That's done. See, this one fits nicely in there. Okay, I'm gonna drill the other 7 and I'll show you the hole saw. Okay, now for the hole saw bit, here's the 11 holes I've drilled, so obviously on the other side we're gonna do this one. So we're just gonna bring the table up a little bit. Okay, this is going to vibrate quite a lot. Again, you obviously don't want to go through both sides, just this one. When you get through this one with the hole saw part, you're done. How this is going to work now. Basically what's going to happen is you're going to drill a 16 mil hole into the wall. I'll show you when I get to that. Now you can place this bolt through this hole inside there and you've got space to tighten it. My sockets fit in here, and then on this side obviously this is already in the wall. This is going to be tight, but you can turn it here because you've got space for that. Okay, I'm going to do the other 7 and then we're going to do the measurements for the cutting and the welding. Okay, I drew myself a jig on my table, a line that I measured from the side of my table that I know is square. I put this piece that's going to go on the wall on that line. And then I measured from that side to my table on the side so that it is the same length everywhere to make sure it is straight, because my square is too short to use it to check, because it's going to show it's square but at the end there it's not going to be straight anymore. So everything is tight now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to weld this. Tack it here, just maybe 2 spots. I'm going to turn it around and tack it again so it doesn't, because when metal gets hot, it expands.
And what happens sometimes what's definitely going to happen, if I finish this whole weld here, it's going to pull away from the other side or push. I don't know. I'm not a welder. I just know it's going to go skew at the bottom. It's not going to be straight anymore. So I'm just going to tack it on two spots there so it doesn't get too hot. Turn it around, tack it again on the other side. Then I'll finish maybe this side and that side and then finish both those sides. I'm going to show you how to weld. You can check other people's videos for that. I'm going to do both and then I'll show you. I'm going to cut that angles. Okay. So yeah, it's the welds. Like I said, I'm not a welder, but I don't think it's too bad. What I did forget, what I could have done before I welded here, I need to make large holes for my wood to go through on the ends here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just going to measure about 50 again, about 50 millimeters, make my cross and drill with a 4 millimeter all the way through, and then use my 30 millimeter hole saw again on both sides just to be able to put the wood in where I'm gonna hang on to. I decided to use wood. It's just a normal broomstick that I buy. As it is cheap, I can take it off when I'm done so it doesn't stand in the rain and the sun and the wind and so on. And if it gets damaged or whatever, I just buy a new one and put it in. So hopefully it works. Okay, so I'm gonna do that. I mean, I'm not gonna show you all the steps. Drill all four of the holes and then we're gonna start with the measurements for the support beam. Okay. So much for all our calculations and shit. I decided the 1.2 meters is too much between these pieces here. So I drew my straight line. I measured my top one again to be straight against the table. And I laid down what I thought was the nicest looking angle for the support beam. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna mark here at the bottom. I'm going to mark here at the bottom a line on this one, and I'm going to mark a line over there on this one. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to transfer the marks made here. I'm going to transfer them to this side, and that side, straight up here. This is going to be straight up now. Yeah, if I put my angle on this one, just transfer it to this side and this one the same, and draw the line here, and I'm going to cut it with the grinder. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to make the other one exactly the same as this one. I'm not going to make any measurements again. When I'm done with that, I'll show you what it looks like when I'm done with that and tell you what the next step is. So you have done my crude cutting. This is what it looks like at the end. On this side, you're gonna have to have to do some repair welding there, it seems. This is the other one. So what I realized was that basically I won't be able to finish this whole thing on the bench. I'm going to weld this properly. Again, tag these two sides, turn it over, tag the two sides, weld this one, then finish the weld there. But when I get to the wall, I'm going to have to measure this distance between this one and this one now. And I'm going to have to put up this bottom one first, and then the top one. And then I can weld this, because I will never be able to get into that hole over there to tighten the roll bolt. I'll have to tighten it before this piece is welded on. So that's what I'm gonna have to do. I'm gonna weld this, I'm gonna weld that part on both of them, then I'll show you, and then I'll see, put it up tomorrow or maybe the day after that. So I've made my markings on the wall. I measured my fingertip height, and then took 8 centimeters off that, and that's the bottom of the top ones. Used a spirit level to go straight down. 610 millimeters down is the bottom level of the bottom ones. Use the same spirit level to get this side, and then marked up the same, and use spirit levels all the way to make sure it's all level. So hopefully it is. Now I'm going to use a 16 mm drill bit to drill these holes for the back of these to put the bottom ones up. And I'm actually considering drilling the top ones as well, as they should be exactly the same as the bottom ones, so that I can put them in directly and then do the welding. Yeah, so I'm going to mark the top ones and I'm going to drill all 8 holes, and then I'm going to put it up and weld it. Show you when I'm done. Okay, so what I suggest you do is you check the depth of your hole, that it goes all the way in. Once you've done that, once you've made sure it goes all the way in, I'll check this one as well. You put them on to your bracket, and once they're on, you put them in. Put them in, and then once you're here, you're gonna tighten them with the socket. The ones I'm using uses a 17 inch socket, 17 millimeter. And then you just turn it in and tighten it. Okay, so I'm going to do that with this one and that one, and I'll show you what it looks like, and then I'm going to do the top ones. Okay, now just to weld the bottom ones. They're both going to have to be a little bit persuaded. This one more, but I mean, it's not a problem. I will be able to get that. Bigger thing for me is, look at this. Okay, well, that is it. In the meantime, I actually decided I'm not going to use wood. I'm going to use 25 millimeter galvanized pipe to put in there, as my hole is 30. So what I'm going to do is, on the pipe, I'm going to drill a small hole through the pipes on both sides, and then use a split pin to keep it where it is. Okay, well, that's it. Thanks for watching.